Well, I keep saying well every time I start a video. I don't know why I do that. Anyway, hello. We are going to talk a little bit about Windows. I love messing with operating system, Windows, Linux, FreeBSD, Haiku, BOS. I don't give a fuck. I love operating system. Microsoft has taken a lot of steps the last almost 10 years to actually really, really improve the security of Windows. And again, that don't mean that you can't get malware and all of that fucking shit. But is Windows starting to become more secure than Linux out of the box? And now all the Linux fanboys are going to yell and scream at me. Viruses, malware, blah, 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 blah. Let's look into this. I'm a little bit behind the curve here, but this has been a thing for a while now. Core isolation under the good old Windows. Virtualization-based security protects the core parts of your device. Let's look into it. What can I do in a virtual machine under the good old Windows 10 for all you Windows 11 haters out there? So you don't have to get your dick in a vice and your tits twisted. We can also do a lot of it under Windows 10. The only problem is I'm in a virtual machine, so a lot of it don't really work that well. Let's close this here. So I can turn it on and off. I don't want to do that because it is a little bit inconvenient. I will go into that in a bit. Learn more. But if you go in here with learn more, core isolations. Core isolation is a security feature of Microsoft Windows that protects core processes of Windows from malicious software by isolating them in memory. It does this by running those core processes in a virtual environment. For the stupid people like me out there in the world and the laymen and the non-so-technical users and all of that fine and handy things. What it means is, though, how you should think about it on a non-technical level is that you're basically putting a condom around these core elements and running them in memory. So it's less accessible to, outside malicious attacks. And you can do, here you can go into memory integrity, also known as hypervised protection code integrity. It helps if you can actually read. And it says here how we can turn it on and off and stuff like that. You can have firmware protection. And it has the Microsoft Defender Credential Guard, basically your credentials, you know. Here, driver blacklist or block list, vulnerable block list. I'm now going to ask my amazing Linux counterparts out there. I'm actually a Linux user myself, but do Linux have firmware protection? Is it something we can install or set up? Or is it as easy to do as to click a button on the Windows? Do we have memory access protection? Again, is it as easy as toggle it on and off on a button within Windows? And how do you set it up under Linux if it's even durable? Do we have memory integrity built into the system in form of core isolation? Do we have core isolation? Can we isolate the Linux kernel and core processes and stuff like that into memory to basically have it in a cocoon of security and walls and great stuff so malicious people can't do it? And is it as easy as turning it on and off again? My 20-something, 4 or 5 years experience with Linux is that you can do some of this and it's really complicated to set up and most of it you can't do. I have looked into Linux security a lot the last year, so it could, I'm a little bit outdated on that also. Even if you could do it under Linux, just that Windows come out with here in the Windows security application in form of a button, fucking a toggle, it's leaps and bounds ahead of Linux, even if you can do it under Linux. Why? Because people don't want to, they want a secure system, but they don't want to sit and fiddle around with fucking config files and get a nerd boner because they changed a period in a fucking config file or on hashtag or fucking comment, so now it's doing something. They just want a button. We are really simple, stupid people, by the way. We just want a button. Here's the thing that a lot of people say, and again, this is not my experience, this is what I've heard from people, is that if you turn this on, it works, but if you turn it off again, I think you need to reinstall Windows. And that could be a good thing or a bad thing. For most people, it's actually a bad thing. I don't want to reinstall my machine. That's why I haven't toggled it on, to be honest, because maybe I should do it and see if I need to reinstall the machine. There could be another video. I'm not sitting here and saying that Windows is more secure than Linux because we don't really know. There are no scientific study that has said 100% that Windows is more secure than Linux and Linux is more secure than Windows. It's all theory and speculations. They are not facts. They are opinions and speculations and theory. And I actually think this is a good step for Windows to do because us Linux users have always bitched and moaned about Linux being unsecure. They are now doing something to mend that. And this should actually, if you hate Windows, you should actually say this is a good thing because they are trying to make it more secure. We should not yell at them for doing that. We should not be angry at them for doing that. We are bits about, we, when I say we, I mean Linux users and Windows users want Linux to be more secure. And they are now going out there to do it. We should say, hey, can you do this also? Or why not make this a little bit more accessible and so on and so on. We should be happy about this and not angry. See you all later. Bye-bye.